outrageous and certainly ironic that in his proclaimed year of education, the governor has proposed cutting $4.8 billion from our public schools. That's the largest education cut ever in the state of California.
The governor proposed education cuts of more than $4 billion. He wants to suspend Proposition 98.
More than 500 layoff notices have been sent to teachers and administrators in San Francisco.
More than 1,000 pink slips have been issued to Orange County teachers.
1,400 teachers from the San Diego Unified School District may lose their jobs.
Among the more than 900 proposed layoffs with San Diego City Schools are 38 nurses.
14,000 teachers received notice of possible layoffs, and many could lose their jobs.
Our estimates are that we're over 18,000, approaching 20,000, and will not be at all surprised if the actual number of notices being mailed in the state of California will be in excess of 20,000.
Most districts say that they are going to be forced to reduce or eliminate music, art, physical education, summer school, sports, nurses, and library services.
Gutting education funding is an assault on students, an assault on educators, and an assault on our communities.
This is totally an attack on education. It's an attack on our future.
Thousands of dedicated teachers around this state may not be back next year. Students will be. And that's the tragedy.
School teachers and parents marching in Southern California in a community. They're upset about the governor's proposed cuts in the education budget.
About 1,000 students outraged over budget cuts in Alameda walked out of class today.
Jan Roach is one of 71 teachers who received a layoff notice. Only hers came her first week back to school after battling breast cancer.
I'm better with, you know, being with the kids than I am at home, worrying about the cancer coming back.
I have thought about not being a teacher just because it's so difficult to keep my job. But I can't imagine doing anything else.
I've done everything I can to become a great teacher, and I think I've done an okay job at it. And to be able to look at my students' face on a daily basis and look at them and know that I'm not going to be able to be with them next year is disheartening. It's much in the same as looking at my child, a two-year-old, and telling her that daddy's not going to have a job next year.
Her teacher got a pink slip. My daughter came into that class not knowing her math at all. Very weak. But because of her teacher, she was able to learn it.
Iván con su maestra. Triste porque ella ya recibió una carta de despido. Maestra, esas lágrimas. Es una verdadera situación muy difícil.
Sí, es muy difícil porque no es justo de que nos corran de donde nosotros estamos. Nosotros vamos a la escuela y trabajamos muy fuerte para que estos niños tengan buenas calificaciones y un buen futuro.
I'm a good worker and I have a strong work ethic. I'll work at McDonald's. You know, I'll get a job, do whatever I have to make sure my children have a home.
Taking it from the schools, it's, we're already dirt poor as it is, scrapping by for any kind of funds is, and then taking away funds on top of it is very demoralizing.
I want my kids to go to college. I want them to have the same opportunities that I had. And with this budget cut, I don't see where that's going to be happening, or it's going to be harder for our kids to make it that far.
We're facing not only the loss of high school athletics and music education in the elementary schools and things like that, but also massive layoffs and school closures at this point.
Teachers may also get less money for summer school, textbooks, and supplies.
You know, it's tight budgets with supplies anyway. What that would probably mean is that it would mean teachers would spend more of their own money.
It's an unprecedented event in our state's history, and we're out to let people know that it's unacceptable to have these draconian cuts that are going to impact what is already the 46th lowest state in funding for student education.
It makes what we're trying to do much, much more difficult. We're trying to provide a well-rounded education for kids, trying to provide sports and music and AP classes and all those things, and cuts like this make it virtually impossible to do our job.
This is my daughter Hope. She, like all of your children, deserves to have 20 students in her class. Nothing else is good enough. There are no good ways to cut the budget. There are better ways to cut the budget than taking it from class size reduction.
I brought my daughter today.
I want her to go to South Oceanside Elementary School. I want to put her in kindergarten, but I don't want her in a room with 30 students.
They chanted, they marched, and they carried signs in both English and Spanish. Today, parents joined teachers and staff of Pico Rivera Public Schools.
Save our schools!
It's become the most potent flashpoint in California's volatile budget battle. Parents, students, and district administrators bracing for cuts and layoffs.
The cuts of the magnitude that are being proposed, simply put, would be devastating to public education. It would be a giant step backwards.
Several hundred educators and parents filled the Capitol's West Steps to decry the governor's proposal to cut nearly $5 billion from public schools.
Dozens rallied outside the Board of Education meeting in University Heights today. They want the school board, or they wanted the school board, to deal with state budget cuts without laying off teachers.
Tomando las calles de Pico Rivera como escenario de su descontento, los encargados de la educación de miles de estudiantes se oponen rotundamente a los cortes presupuestales propuestos por el gobernador de California.
Right now you're looking at live pictures at Leonard Flynn Elementary School in the Mission District. You can see quite a bit of students, parents, teachers and community members there chanting and letting their feelings be known about these budget cuts.
In the Bay Area today, students at John Sweat High School in Crockett upset over the possibility of losing six teachers, decided to start their day by refusing to go to class. They gathered on their football field and then marched across the Carquinez Bridge to the district office in Rodeo to protest the proposed cuts.
The Alameda Educational Foundation staged an unusual protest this afternoon. People went around to different sites throughout the city and stood in garbage cans to demonstrate how the educational system in California is being thrown away.
They should not be on the backs of our children. Why is he choosing the children? They don't vote. We do. It's time that they start listening to what we parents as voters say.
I am just so, so concerned about the future of not only our teachers, but our students.
Nosotros vamos a comprometernos a seguir luchando para asegurar que las escuelas tengan los fondos necesarios para seguir adelante.
Some people would say, though, that the governor in the last few years has given education what they wanted.
Some people aren't paying close attention then.
Students didn't create this budget crisis, and their education shouldn't be ransomed to solve it.